Let me recap the topics that we discussed. We developed a simple reports using Wizard. You can ask any questions if you have. Develop master detail report using Wizard and develop a simple report manually and develop a master detail report manually and bind parameters, lexical parameters. These topics we discussed in the report builder. Okay. So the agenda for today's class is summary columns in the same report builder only. Summary columns, formula columns, and placeholder columns. And data links. So these topics we will discuss. The next triggers will be there. Those triggers we can discuss on Monday. And then we can go ahead with the Oracle applications registration part. Okay, so summary columns, formula columns, placeholder columns, and data links. Okay. So fine, let me open the report builder quickly. Just these are all the previous reports. Let me close this. Okay. First, let us talk about the summary column. Basically, the summary column is you want to find something like sum or count or max or minimum. Those are all the summary columns. Okay. This is nothing but what? Finding sum or average or count, max, min of from a field basically. By seeing this you can understand sum means it should be the number field, average it should be the number, count it can be anything, for example number of records, max number field, minimum number field. Okay. And formula column is where you want to apply some logics. Okay, this is to apply the formula and execute at runtime. Execute at runtime. Example, calculate tax on or using salary. Okay. At runtime, that salary, based on the salary, we want to calculate the tax. Placeholder column, it's like a variable, or you can say it's a global variable, which can be used any place across the report. Or any place in the report. Okay. Data links is to link or build the relation between two queries, two or more queries. Okay. That's about the data link. For example, you have Q1 and you have Q2. So how to do that? For that we have to use this. Okay, I hope this is clear. This is this is brief description. In the document you will have detail, but this is enough because you have everything. Sum you can understand, average you can understand. I'm going to show you the examples, what the summary column is doing, what the formula column is going to do. When you want to apply some calculations at runtime, you have to use formula columns. Placeholder column is, it's something like a column, it's like a variable, but if you declare any variable inside a block, right, or inside a program that is applicable for that program only. You cannot use that in outside the program. But basically a placeholder column is, once you create a placeholder column, you can use anywhere in any query. For example, you have different queries. You don't want to create multiple variables. So you can have one variable, you can use it. That's the advantage of placeholder column. Okay, it's a variable which can be used in various queries. Okay, so instead of having different types of variables, you can save the memory and you can reduce the length of the program and many things you can use. So that's what is a placeholder column. Data link, that is to link between, like you have multiple queries. Okay, so you can build the relation between those queries. So we'll try to finish all these topics today. Okay, let's start with the summary columns. First, what we'll do, we'll have one example, okay, to achieve all these things except this. To achieve this, we'll have one requirement. So example, develop the report to show below output. Okay. Example, we have a table, employee table we have. It's not the Oracle Apps table, but you can take any table. To calculate something like tax, etc., we can use this table, employee table. Okay, it's not there. That's fine. So we have another table like PO line sort table. So in the PO line sort table, we'll have PO line ID, PO header ID, and item ID, item reason, etc., and also item description. Unit price and quantity you have, right? So this unit price and quantity, we need to multiply to get the PO amount, correct? Unit price and quantity, we have to multiply to get the PO amount. So that is nothing but what? Total amount. After that, we'll try to apply some discount on the total amount, okay, using these formula columns. So finally, what I'm expecting here is in the output, PO number, okay, item, quantity, price, the total amount. Okay, total amount. The total amount is not there in the table. We have to calculate it. And also we wanted to apply some discount. Okay, based on the total amount. Okay, this is a requirement. This is the requirement. PO number, item, quantity, price, total amount, discount. Okay. Now we want total number of records also and the sum of this quantity, sum of the price. Sum of the price and sum of this total, sum of this discount, and total how many records are there. Okay, that one also we can take it. So now in this, to get this output in the report builder, we'll write the query first. Okay, we'll take the PO number from the PO header sort table and item, quantity, price, total amount, discount. Okay. So this discount will calculate using the formula column. Using the formula column, we'll calculate this discount. And the summary columns will take these summary columns using this summary column. Placeholder column is also will take to calculate when you calculate something discount, right? The discount we have to assign to the variable, right? That for that we will use placeholder column. Okay. So what's the first step? Let's start with the query first. We wanted to have a query for this PO number, item, quantity, price, and total amount. So total amount is not there, but it's very easy. Just we have to multiply quantity into price, right? So we'll go here, select PO number we want, right? So ph.segment1. Okay, that's a PO number that we can take it from the PO headers all table. And from the PO lines, you can get everything like item ID, you can get okay, PL dot item ID. You can get the item name using this. And item ID is fine. Item description is there, so you can take that PL dot item description. And we have quantity, price, right? So we take those unit price and quantity. Let's take PL dot quantity, PL dot unit price. Okay, quantity into price. That's it. So total amount, you can take PL dot quantity into PL dot unit price as total. Yeah, from PO header solve, that is PH, and PO line solve, that is PL. Okay, this we'll take directly from the headers table, this header ID, right? So PL dot header ID. Header ID. We can write a subquery here. Can write select segment one from PO underscore headers all where PL where PO header ID equal to PL dot PO header ID. Okay. Just I'm writing a subquery. So I'm taking the PO header ID from PO lines all table. And I'm going to the main table PO header solve where PO header ID equal PL dot PO header ID. That is the PO number. That's the segment one basically, but I'm taking it as PO number. Org ID also we have to join because in the same org in the different same PO can be in the different organizations. I mean the number. So that's what we have to give org ID equal to PL dot org ID. Let's see how it will run. So now headers table is not required. Because we are taking from the subquery, right? So I'll take the header ID from the headers table, lines table, and going to the PO header sort table and joining this and getting the segment one. That is the PO number. So item ID, item description, all are there. Let's run this. Comma is required here. Perfect. So PO number is coming, everything is coming. PO header ID. So now PO header ID, PO number, item, item description. Item ID is there. Item instead of item ID, I want item name. So you can have a one more subquery here. Select segment one from MDL system items B where inventory item ID equals okay item ID. The item ID which is coming from PO lines table. But this should be the unique, okay? So you have to give distinct. Give it as item name. Okay, so perfect. Total is coming, quantity into unit price. This is 2000. So for example, if you look at this, 10 into 50, 500, okay? So this is our query. Okay, this is our query. Now we'll build the report. So we got this output, right? Whatever the output we want, PO number is there, item is there, quantity, price, total amount is there. The summary columns and discount, we'll do it from the report builder. So let's take this. We'll go to report builder. We'll develop the manual report. Click here. Manual, click OK. Default data model is open. Click here. Click here. Copy your query. Okay. Click OK. No. value not allowed. Value not allowed. I'm sorry, not connected to Oracle. You can connect here. It's already connected. Okay, it's created. Okay, it was not connected to the database, that's fine. So the query is created, fine. Now we'll go back and we'll create a paper layout. Okay, we'll create the paper layout. You can take the repeating frame first. Okay, so what's our output? Our output is PO number first. So let's have one field that is for the PO number. Okay, and item. So let's have item here, quantity, quantity is small, right? So take quantity, price, you can extend this. It's not that we have to fix, we need to set everything inside this box. It's not like that. So you can extend that, you can expand to, you can go to the main section, go to property, okay, by pressing F4, you can increase this. Now 8.5 is there, right? Let me put 9.5. Okay, close this. Now go to paper layout. So it is extended. So you can extend like this. Okay, so fine. So this is PO number, this is item, this is quantity, this is price, and what else? Total amount. So we'll take total amount is another field, and discount. Okay, we'll take discount also. Right, all the columns we have taken. Now we will attach the source. What is the source for this? Just straight away can go to the report inspector, that is property palette, can attach the source here, G PO head value. Close this. Now we'll attach the source to all this. F1, right click, go to property palette, property inspector, PO number, right? That's a segment number, but we have alias as PO number. So we can take PO number. PO number, close this. That is coming from the query. The next item. So we have item name as alias, right? So we can take that item name. I'm not printing item description, item name I'm printing. Quantity, whatever the columns you want, you can take it. So quantity is there, fine. And go to this price. What's the column name? Unit price, right? So unit price. And we have total amount, right? So go back to the property, total amount. Yeah, I think it is total. Yeah, total. Okay, so I'm giving total there. Click close. So now we have to calculate discount. We don't have discount, right? In our query, we don't have discount because there are a lot of conditions we have to apply. If total is this, then this much is the discount is applicable, right? So we will write all those conditions. Now for time being, I'll remove this. Okay, I will remove this. Later we will add it again. Next, we'll attach the source. We have attached the source and everything. Now close this. No gaps. If you have gap in the output, also the gap will come. So we wanted to make sure it is designed correctly. Okay. So now we'll put some headings here. Purchase report. Then we'll put some headings here. This is PO number. This is item name. This is quantity. This is price. This is total, right? Total amount. Okay. So if you want page numbers, date, everything, that you can put it. So Control Shift K and Control Shift R. First we'll see the output is coming or not. So perfect amount is, report is working fine. So now if you don't want any lines, you can just remove them. Okay, you can select, press Control A, you can select it, you can click here. And no line. Okay, if you don't want any lines, but if you want something like this one, you can also add here itself directly. Okay, anyone in the lines between this, this is also possible like this. You can design here itself. Okay. So now we'll have one more column here, discount. But before that, if you want some summaries, okay. So we'll see the headings are coming, not coming in the all the pages. So what you can do is you can go to the paper layout again. We'll take, just hold the shift key and select everything, all the headings that you want to repeat in all the pages. Including these lines also. Go to property and print object on all pages. Okay. Control Shift K and Control Shift R. So now we can see these headings in all the pages. So perfect. Next. Here no total amount is coming because there is no quantity. So wherever the items are there, items are coming, quantity, price. So it's working as expected. Okay. Now go to paper layout. So the report design part is done. This is how the report is designed. Okay. So now what is the next step? The next step is we want to have summary columns first. Okay, we'll have summary columns for item, quantity, price, and total amount. We'll take the summary columns. Okay, quantity, price, and total amount. So go to data model first. Go to the data model. Here, how many summary columns you want? Quantity, price, total, right? Three summary columns. So this summary column you can take. This is called summary column. We have to go to data model. Click here. You can click anywhere. You want outside the query, right? So we have to take outside. So click here. Again, take one more summary column. Take one more summary column. So next, right click. One is for quantity, okay? Quantity total, how much quantity? So go to property palette. Sum of what? Sum of quantity. And this. And next, this is sum of unit price. Go to property inspector again. Sum of unit price. And again, you can take this. Right click, go to property palette. Sum of what? Sum of total. Okay. So we have three summary columns, right? Summary columns we have. Now close this, go to paper layout. Here you can add your summary columns. You need to create one field, sum of quantity, sum quantity, right? You can have one field here. And right click, go to property. Now the summary column that we created, right? That we have to attach. There are three summary columns. One is for quantity, one is for price, one is for total. So this CS1 we'll attach here. Close this. Similarly, price. We'll create one more field here. So go to property again, CS2 you can attach. CS2. Now total, right? The total for sum of total, this one. So you can take this and have one more field here. Right click, property palette, go to CS3. Okay, let's see how the output will come. Control Shift K. And you want page wise, in each page if you want to see, you can select them, go to property palette and show it in all the pages. Print object. Object on all pages. Close this. If you want it last page, you can leave like that. Or you can change the property to last page. Control Shift again, Control Shift R.